Mike, thank you very much. We are here in Boulder, Colorado, on the campus of the University of Colorado, getting set for a nightcap from the Pac-12 as number four UCLA takes on the Colorado Buffaloes. And hello there, everybody. Justin Kutcher alongside Bill Raftery. And Raft, we know about this UCLA team, how good offensively they are. How does Colorado slow them down defensively?
Well, I think the big thing is transition D and the ability in the half court to maintain your principles. And, you know, we both have high principles. It's interesting. They run so many cute little things. You've got to stay at home on your guy and yet help the open man.
All right, let's take a look at our starting lineups for tonight's game. For UCLA, obviously, we talk about Lonzo Ball, but Bryce Alford in the backcourt with him. And TJ Leaf has been so good as the other freshman. For the Buffaloes, Derek White, he kind of makes this team go. And George King, can he get things going from the outside for Colorado? Colorado is in white. UCLA is in their Bruin blue. And they win the tip, and here is Lonzo Ball.
And right now, Justin Kutcher. Colorado goes. Minutemen. Little cross screen pop.
Leaf has it taken away. Xavier Johnson.
Open look.
The other way. It's Wells, the baseline jumper, a rare miss for him. And on the box out, we're going to have a foul call.
It might be White down underneath. I'm not sure. I didn't get a good look, or
it looks like
Deleon Brown.
Deleon Brown is going to be called for the foul.
Boy, this is too easy right there. Two open looks for a guy who's unhurried.
Welsh finally puts one in, and it's 2-0 UCLA early.
Now you watch practice, that little screen by Welsh, he gets the same look. Goodness, you can't leave him. Automatic from 15-17. And King and Fortune really have to ring the bell outside. I think they're going to help this team.
Derek White gets inside, puts up the runner, no. Good rebound by Gordon. And this is out of bounds, going to be off Colorado, and it's UCLA ball.
Yeah, Gordon Torney got some little body contact. Welsh may lead the country in blocks without getting off his feet. It's utterly amazing. You know, always in a good position, walls up. Here's that little baseline bump.
Hamilton, the pull-up jumper, long.
Nice
rebound
tip.
Out to him. Kick out. Leaf for three. He can hit from downtown. TJ Leaf, the 6'10" freshman, is shooting it at 48.6% from three-point land.
And how about him keeping it alive twice now with the slap back?
King with the left.
Pretty. This kid's amazing. Terrific rebounder, both on the offensive and defensive glass. Tough, quick reaction.
Leave to the corner.
They use both sides of the floor, make you stretch because they can shoot threes.
Alford misses a deep three. King has not shot the ball well from the outside this year and has his pocket picked by Ball. 2-on-1. Alford puts it in.
How about that? You make your decision. I'll give it to you nice and early. Nice attack by Alford.
7-2 UCLA leading here in the first couple of minutes over Colorado, who has won 15 of their last 16 here at the Coors Event Center.
And this guy can drill it there.
Johnson nice for Johnson. Three does just that.
He hadn't had many touches early here. Very effective going either way. Even though he's a lefty, his dominant hand, he doesn't mind going to the right.
A 41% shooter from downtown coming off a big game against Arizona. And a turnover. Here's Johnson the other way. Against Leaf, goes at him, and he draws the foul.
You notice how all the guys are trying to wall up. Referee's doing a better job. That was a foul, no question about it. But you don't see a fumble like this too often by Ball. And good help and recovery. A little tardy.
That foul against TJ Leaf is his first, the team's first. And at the free throw line is Xavier Johnson.
Yeah, he is a tough match because he's quick, a nice touch. Pretty good around the rim as well.
A 69% free throw shoot on the season. Misses the first at 26 points at Arizona on Saturday when Colorado lost 82-73. He makes one of two at the line and makes it a one-point game.
Well, last year he had that Achilles problem, but a big factor for this club this year if they're going to make some noise.
Hamilton. Hamilton gets it right back.
They've got excellent shooters all over the floor.
Hamilton for three. And the weak side rebound, easy one for Derek White.
High ball screen slip, nice move.
With the left, it's Wesley Gordon getting fouled. He'll go to the free throw line for two. And that foul is against TJ Leaf, and that's number two against Leaf.
Did they give it to him or Welsh? Check that, that was Welsh involved underneath.
It was against Leaf.
Wow.
And Steve Alford is saying, come on, guys, that was on 40.
I think he's right. He wasn't even near the play.
Gordon misses the free throw. Let's take a look.
Oh, there see, it on is. The right. Yep. Yeah, okay, they're right. You got him first. Well, that changes things a little bit.
Yeah, it does. So TJ Leaf goes to the bench. GJ Golemon comes in, but TJ Leaf, he's coming off three straight double-doubles. He's the team's leading scorer at 17.4 points per game, 9.1 rebounds per game.
Mm-hmm.
That's a big loss early on here in foul trouble.
It's just the little things he does to contribute. You mentioned the slapbacks. Goldman, a guy that can step out and make threes as well. Look at this pull-up.
Gets the roll.
His daddy couldn't do that, I know that. Knight wouldn't let him.
Brown for three, an air ball. King gets the loose ball, can't finish. Gordon there, he puts it back, no. Another rebound for Brown and a fresh 30. White attacking the hoop. He gets fouled and he'll go to the free throw line.
Well, that's all because of King. You mentioned him. What a tiger on the offensive glass to get that opportunity to finish the deal. Boy, White showed some speed, didn't he, attacking that rim? They got to finish those opportunities around the glass, though. Here's a little blow-by.
We were just talking before he came on the air. You look at Derek White. He played his first 3 years at UCCS, which is University of Colorado, Colorado Springs. He averaged 25.8 points per game his last year there. This year, he's averaging almost 16 points per game. He had 35 at Arizona State. You wonder, I mean, this guy went from UCCS to the Pac-12, and he's doing it in a Power 5 conference.
Well, you say that with envy. You probably felt that you were cheated the opportunity to go to a big program. But, you know, sometimes in high school, they're not quite as good, and then you start and play a lot of minutes. You improve.
Golemon posting up.
Steps.
Yep. Good defense by Johnson. And a good start here for the Buffaloes. They haven't done it from the floor, just 2 for 7. But they're tied up with UCLA at 9. We're all tied up at 9 here in Boulder between number 4 UCLA and Colorado. And for this Colorado team, you go back to December 7th when they played number 13 Xavier here at home. And it was Derek White who took over down the stretch. He scored 9 of the final 12 points for the Buffaloes, including a key block down the stretch. They won it by 2. And that's one of their signature wins on this season so far, as they got 10 wins in the non-conference schedule. And look at what they've done against top 25 opponents this year.
Of course, Texas, you got to throw in, was a pretty good win at the time as well. And they are very good. I was here a couple of years ago when they beat Oregon, who was undefeated. I think they were 12-0. It's a raucous atmosphere here, much like the lounge last night.
Now, one thing that does bode well for UCLA is that school is not in session yet.
Mm-hmm.
So the student body is not here, as Dominique Collier has checked in for Colorado.
Three-quarter pressure handled nicely and pick and pop.
Johnson's three. Got it. Nothing but net.
He's got a little action coming back, scraping the floor with the fingernails. But you've got to get up on him.
Ball to answer. And the rebound by Torrey Miller, who's checked in for the Buffs.
Lonzo Ball does that a few times a game, generally successfully. Defense backs up. He drills him. Empty side, ISO.
Johnson, that's a 2.
Push going
and
the
it's
other
a
way.
Push, yep. The foul will go against number 14, Torrey Miller.
Torrey Miller's played some good minutes, I think, on the road. It's Arizona State and Arizona. There's that pick and pop, just lack of coverage, lack of reaction, and the guys have difficulty showing and recovering.
A 10-2 run for the Buffaloes as they lead by three.
A little flex screen, and that's that pick and pop, but forget about it. That's magic for him.
Thomas Welsh, he is that catch and shoot guy at 7 feet, and he is money from the baseline.
Well, they worked on that. Colorado to defend it. Just you open up, over help.
Johnson against Goleman.
He steps two. Yep.
And substitution now for UCLA. Aaron Holiday is coming in for Bryce Alford. And Aaron Holiday is a guy to watch off the bench.
And UCLA does a nice job with their screening. They've got a jump shooter in the corner, or the pop man, generally Welsh. Guys get those happy feet, don't they? You don't know football. Quarterbacks get it, right? But they
Absolutely.
Got big bodies coming after them.
Ball, the kickback.
Steps two.
Talk about happy feet.
Yeah.
Third turnover for UCLA. A couple of substitutions for Colorado. Wesley Gordon's back in. Josh Fortune, number 44, has checked in as well.
Yeah, Goldman, he can drive it. He's a good passer. Just a little bit of a hurry.
I also like how he goes by Gigi as opposed to his full name.
Helps you out, huh?
Big time.
You've been in the room all day working on your phonics.
Gigi, Gigi. It took a while.
Good challenge of the jumper.
The rebound for Welsh. Here comes Ball looking to push.
Holiday's such a tough competitor. Nice pump fake.
And a foul will be called against Torrey Miller. But the defense was good because they made Welsh put the ball on the floor. He couldn't catch and shoot, but then the foul was committed. That's number two against Miller. So he's going to have to go to the bench, and Lucas Seawert will come in.
I'll tell you, the crowd doesn't like the nickel dime calls, huh?
You know, it's a late start. They don't want to be here all night.
Here's the guy that I think really lights this team up when he comes in. Well, that was Hamilton that time. He's had some open looks. They got to get him back shooting. He's not shooting as well in the conference, right?
Collier, a little hesitation on the poked away from behind. It looked like he touched it last, but they're going to say it's out of bounds off of UCLA, so it will stay Colorado ball. Ike Anibogu has checked in now for UCLA for Welsh.
Now this kid is a physical presence on the floor. Pretty good little low post game. And make free throws.
If you joined us late, TJ Leaf picked up two quick fouls for UCLA, so he's on the bench right now. Shot clock at six. Collier's three is in and out. And Anibogu with the rebound.
Good balance so far early. Give him an open look, though. That's where they hurt you.
In and out for Lonzo Ball. He looks down, couldn't believe it. Collier, the pull-up jumper. Line drive, no. And a foul stay right here. This will be going against UCLA, and that will go against Gigi Goleman.
They got on the wrong side. This team really gets hits the glass nicely. They've had some great looks, just unable to convert.
Fourth team foul. Number two against Goleman. Dangerous pass into the corner.
Boy, they had a perfect trap there. Good hands. Nice the dial.
Ball. With the steal.
Look at this
goes
pass.
Goes up for Hamilton.
I mean, he was lobbing it to the rim.
Holiday for three. Got it.
Great denial on the perimeter. Set up that run out.
Live ball turnover. And UCLA turns into points. Seawert, the baseline jumper. That's in and out.
He practiced well, I thought. Dad said the same thing.
Holiday, the pull-up jumper is good.
This kid, I'm telling you, he's the edge. He's in ready, competitive.
16-12, UCLA leading. Now 16-15 after Derek White's three-pointer.
They got to do a better job handling the screen. They got to recover a little bit better.
Hamilton gets in the paint. His pull-up
ready.
Gets the roll. Isaac Hamilton coming off 15 points in the victory over Stanford on Sunday. Fortune open for three.
They gotta have
too strong.
Gotta have him make them.
Look at that. Look ahead.
A little too far.
Too much. Holiday misconnecting with Hamilton.
A little more loft on that trajectory would have had him.
A three-point game with 11:48 to go here in the first half. UCLA leading Colorado. UCLA on top by three over Colorado here in the first half. And on Saturday, it's a Big East basketball doubleheader here on FS1. Josh Hart and number three Villanova take on St. John's. Then number 15 Xavier battles number 12 Butler. A Big East basketball doubleheader begins at high noon Saturday on FS1.
Tough at Hinkle. They can get after you. But right now, it's interesting. Leaf out of the game, and I don't think we'll see him at all. But some guys will insert, try and get a couple of baskets, get a guy out. But there's no need. They're in touch. Sort of a herky-jerky beginning for UCLA.
Really a herky-jerky beginning for both teams. Colorado's in this game, but they're 4 of 15 from the floor. Three turnovers.
Got to be careful of the offensive foul. See what, as he turns his back.
And there's a travel. There's a fourth turnover. So they have as many turnovers as field goals here in this first half for Tad Boyle in his seventh year as the head coach here at Colorado. And the fact that they're in this game right now, they're lucky.
You can't beat people of this level by making mistakes. But the one thing I will say, you cannot cross over now off a jab step. It's an automatic call, even if a kid does it properly.
Hamilton along the baseline puts it in.
He sort of like understands the space, what he can get away with, and they do give him plenty of room to roam.
Bryce Peters has checked in.
Nice pick
and roll. Knocked out of bounds, and it will stay Colorado ball with 19 on the shot clock.
The big guys really pass nicely to one another.
George King will inbound. Where is the offense going to come from for Colorado right now?
I mentioned King's got to make some shots. Fortune not on the floor. He had a good open look earlier. There's one.
Would you say had to make some shots?
Yeah.
Who was that?
That's that guy. King drilling it big time.
Holiday, the answer.
How about that?
Oh, in and out. They've had a couple of those.
Right on. He also could have driven left hard. They had emptied the side for him.
Collier for Gordon. Attacking the hoop. Good take against Sonny Bogu. And Wesley Gordon coming off a season high 16. At Arizona on Saturday has tied this at 20 and gets the crowd into it.
Collier made the play, though, forced him to go to the rim.
Holiday's pass.
Numbers.
Here comes Peters. Peters to the hoop. Is that going to be goaltending?
I think it was under. I think it was on the way up.
The foul will be called against Bryce Alford.
They've done a nice job. We mentioned about being in the right spot defensively and hit it into the glass. That's legal. A good piece of officiating. Of course, fans don't agree with me.
That was on the backboard.
Glad they didn't have the audio.
Peters missed the first, and look who's back in here for UCLA playing with two fouls. It's TJ Leaf.
It's almost like a teaching situation where, you know, play within yourself, don't reach, see if we can get some offense going, and then get him out on occasion on a defensive trip.
One of two at the line gives Colorado the lead.
Pace right now, I think, favors Colorado.
Absolutely.
Getting themselves back in position, making the half-court offense work. There's that squeeze play they like to run. The elevator play, they might call it.
Shot clock at eight.
Nice pass.
Sonny Bogu, short. And a good rebound pulled down by one of the best rebounding guards in the country in George King. And King all the way short. The follow by Gordon, no, kept alive. And here's Lonzo Ball with it.
Head up, always finds the right guy.
Ball hesitated on the three. Leaf.
He loves that trap step. They were ready for it.
Ball the deep three. Got it.
What a great piece of defense. Greer was going through the offense of UCLA, and that was one of the plays. He gets it at Lane Leaf, and there's a drop step back.
Peters, the step back. Got it.
Nice. Good elevate. He's got a couple inches. A little Beckham look.
Bryce Peters averages under 3 points a game. He's come off the bench and been a spark for the Buffaloes. Foul away from the ball.
Well, Holiday really voices his opinion. He had used the brush screen. He wanted the ball, didn't get it.
The foul is called against Bryce Peters.
This is where he wanted the basketball. He didn't get it. He was really disgusted. See him slapping his hands? Yeah, he is interesting.
That was the first against Peters' team's fourth.
Nice.
Alford. Pump fake for three.
Do you know what legs you have to do that? Because when you pump, you go up a little. Now you have to get a new charge and nail it. Pick and pop, where they have done this nicely.
Johnson short on the three. Alford gets the rebound. Quickly ahead for Holiday. Hey. Holiday, a good take to the hoop. He really is something special off the bench for the Bruins. Peters, look at that crossover and take.
And Holiday really shouldn't have fouled. He had Welsh there. That's a little communication. You know, just ride him. Don't touch. I'll bail you out.
The first foul against Holiday, team sixth. And Peters goes to the free throw line.
Now you've done football here, right?
Yeah. I have, yeah. And the football team had a phenomenal season this year.
And socially, it's a very active community.
It is.
Just checking on your social life. I know there's a lot of evenings here.
It's always better when you're in town.
Well, that's nice of you. Beautiful area, beautiful campus.
One of two at the line, but Miller gets the offensive rebound.
Loading up in the block, Miller. He's got a game down here.
Lost it on the way up. Johnson there with the right hand. He's a lefty, puts it in with the right. And the official went down.
He's
that was Gregory Nixon. He's okay, he's back up in position.
He came from the snow country, right? Seattle, he said, out of Cove, Portland. Nice using the screen. And they get Welsh.
Yep. And that is going to be the 17th foul against UCLA with 7:34 to go. A good one here early on. Bryce Peters has been a bright spot off the bench for the Buffs. A two-point game here in Boulder, Colorado, trailing number four, UCLA. Let's go inside the huddle with Colorado's coach, Tad Boyle.
Yeah, that's a good shot you had right there. Just get that thing moved. We'll get any shot we want down there. Keep going to the boards offensively, all right? Got a guard down here. Now Holiday's in a couple. Got to make him work to catch it.
You got Holiday. You got Ball.
All right? You got Holiday.
He's got Allbird. He's got Ball.
Hey!
All about transition D. I mean, we do that. They like to put three guys on the glass. It's more like two and a half. You cannot concede open opportunities. Holiday, he's right. This kid just is amazing how he can decimate your defense. Very confident performer. When you take away the deep one, he puts it on the deck.
But what they've talked about, all right, don't give up fast break points. So far, two for UCLA in the game. Crash the offensive glass. Seven so far in the game. And there's a reason why they trail by just two.
They're solid on the glass every game. It's a matter of, I think, of making a couple of shots. And that's why I mentioned Fortune and King. When they get the opportunity, making that three really helps the rest of the guys.
Miller missed the front end of a one-on-one. Alford sets the screen.
He really keeps active. Pop.
Holiday, the
short
step back for three.
My mistake. I thought he got a little pull there, but this kid is a gamer.
I think he just looked over you and said, Mr. Raftery.
Mind your own.
Yeah, that's 10 points for me here in the first half, okay?
Right off the timeout, too, saying, hey, who's got him?
White, the pull-up from the elbow. Gets the roll. Wow.
Tender rims.
You should get out there and shoot.
No, I saw some of our staff taking shots today. Dewey embarrassed us.
Welsh.
And nobody on the glass at all when he posts up like that.
3-point lead for UCLA. Derek White hasn't gotten going yet. Brown finds White. His baseline jumper, no. And the rebound into the hands of Isaac Hamilton.
It's a different break without ball in there.
Leaf, the corner three, got fouled and puts it in. And the foul is against Xavier Johnson.
I thought Holiday really stuck with that. Loose ball, got it. Got it to Leaf. This kid's got a great looking stroke. The way he gets himself organized. And just tough in terms of defending him because he's good at the low box area. He's good at the elbow. And, of course, he can stretch it in the corner. When you close out, you've got to decide. Are you going to run by, jump stop, skip out?
Cannot convert the four-point play, but gives UCLA a six-point lead with just about 6 minutes to go here in the first half. Trying a quick tumble against Johnson, and he flushes it.
A smart, though. They knew Leaf had the two. Post up the southpaw. He just backed off. A little nickel-dimer out here.
Yep. Against Bryce Peters. And Johnson, he's doing some talking there for Colorado.
Just play. A little incident. A couple of games ago, and but he does beat you up in a lot of different ways. We noticed the three, and that time a little drop step curl. Send it in.
Thomas Akiazili has checked in for the first time for Colorado, number zero, replacing Peters.
And when you see his effort, that kid leaves it all out there.
Hamilton, good jump stop. Can't get the roll. White, the step back jumper. No good. And the rebound by Leaf.
I'm sure
the fumble there.
I'm sure the coaches on the bench are talking about Leaf. At what point do we take him out? Make sure he doesn't get three, but that's a pretty strong move. When you shoot the ball, you own the guy. And he's in Never Neverland. So you stay up tight. Look at that size, the agility.
And give credit to TJ Leaf as a freshman. Playing with those two fouls, that move, he just drew the second foul against Xavier Johnson, who's been the offense for Colorado here in the first half. As Leaf knocks down the free throw, Johnson goes to the bench. George King comes back in.
It's all under control, though. He circled. He didn't attack the defender. Knew he could get that little kiss opportunity.
And now Lonzo Ball will come back in for Holiday. You look at TJ Leaf, what he has done in his freshman season. You know, all the hooplas around Lonzo Ball. This guy's kind of flown under the radar. Mm-hmm. And he has done one heck of a job for the Bruins.
Well, you'll be able to get a loan from him in a couple of years.
Yeah.
He's a keeper. 1-2-2, a little half breath. They did it earlier.
Brown wasn't ready for the pass, able to save it.
Here's the zone. They like to go to the elbow with the pass and then underneath. 1-2-3, trying to save Leaf as well.
White gets inside, gets the foul, and he's going to the free throw line to try to convert the 3-point play.
Once you beat the front line of defense, now it is well step up. They hit the slip pass or the opportunity to go right at his chest and finish the deal. You are really hung up on this kid going to a smaller college. I mean,
you're the one that just brought it back up. I didn't say it again.
They play good basketball there. Kids fall through the cracks. What could you say?
But makes it a 3-point game, and also that was foul number two against Welsh. He went to the bench. Anibogo comes back in for UCLA. Anibogo. Good defense by Wesley Gordon, and now a foul against Anibogo, and Gordon will go to the free throw line.
That's just frustration, really. He just threw that up. He'll get some polish to his game. When I was younger, I used to have a body like that. Boy, whatever happened. But he's going to learn how to play. He's a great rebounder, strong, tough kid. How about what Steve's been able to do last year? I mean, just incredible. The heat he took and had to listen to with style, I must admit. He even gave a year back thinking, hey, none of us did our job. And they just came in with a wonderful class to compliment the seniors. And the one thing he told both of us, a lot of these are coaches' kids. And the maturity, the way they get along, the way they play with one another.
The basketball IQ. Crowd on its feet in a one-point game. 4.5 to go here in the first half.
Nice denial. Nice three-quarter.
Alford for three. That's good. Wow. How about silencing a crowd?
But how about the passing lane that presents now for the post? They just stretch you so far. Still the zone look.
7 points here in the first half for Alford. UCLA is 7 of 13 from three-point land.
A nice trap situation. That's where they wanted the ball, that elbow. Look at King pursue.
Jump ball, possession arrow, Colorado. I said he's one of the best rebounding guards in the country. He's got 5 double-doubles on the year. He's 6'6".
I know, he's quick to the ball. His understanding also, when you know you've missed the shot, you know exactly where it's going. But his pursuit is amazing.
He averages over 7 rebounds per game, does George King. Dangerous outlet pass to Dominique Hollier.
Nice little move. You get Leaf out now. Protect him. He got some valuable minutes.
In the corner, King for three.
Oh,
his
helps.
Second.
That helps. That makes them a different team when he's lighting it up.
Back to a one-point game. Hamilton for Holiday. Ball, the deep three, got it again.
Well, they have confidence. They don't make mistakes because they know the next guy can drill them big time.
...42-38. Both teams starting to heat up, especially from downtown.
Nice job defensively over here by Ball. Showed topside, King couldn't get free.
Collier looking for Gordon. Great anticipation by Hamilton. And a foul will be called against Dominique Collier.
How about the help, huh? The Colorado hanging tough in front of the home crowd. Use that little post. How about this? Send it in. Gets it to the rim and the ability to get White downtown.
Thank you.
All right, Mike, looking forward to that. Here we've got 2:59 to go in the first half, 42-38. UCLA leading. Aaron Holiday off the bench. He's got 10 points, 2 assists, 4 of 5 from the floor. Bryce Alford's got 10 for the Bruins. And don't forget, I mean, they did this really much of the first half with T.J. Leaf on the bench, picked up those two quick fouls, but then give him credit because he came back in, didn't pick up any more. And he also got 2 fouls against Johnson.
Yeah, 9 minutes is all he got, but he did a masterful job of getting something out of him. Good, solid contributions. Went zone a little bit. And Steve Alford massaged his way to halftime.
Isaac Hamilton knocks down both. Back up to a 6-point lead for the Bruins. Thomas Akiazili, not a guy looking for a shot. 1 of 17 from three-point land on the season.
He's a driver and finds people. Pretty good defense this trip. Everybody solid. Great denial. Keep them on the perimeter.
Shot clock at 7. White, little hesitation. Hangs. He gets bumped, and White will go back to the free throw line.
And that's the second time I've noticed where the big guy is ready to block a shot. Hamilton with the foul, and you've got the big guy looming large back there. You got to let him take over. Don't get that cheapy.
It's the first against Hamilton. White has now made 18 in a row at the free throw line. Back into the game is Thomas Welsh for UCLA, who's got 2 fouls as well. as Gigi Goleman and TJ leave. So the big men in foul trouble for UCLA. But at this point, Steve Alford trying to get some offense on the floor as they get the ball back going down the floor.
How about the game that White had against Arizona State? Unbelievable numbers. Big goal against Xavier early in the year as well.
Alford got fouled by Azili.
They have so many breakdown guys. That's what makes them a tough out. You just can't key on one particular player on UCLA.
Think about this. They've got six guys averaging double figures. Mm-hmm. Six.
It's unheard of. Well, they spread the wealth, something that I'd like to see you do a little bit of. And they are unabashed on that offensive end of making the extra look going side to side. And it's simple. I mean, it's nothing complex. It's just put them in the right spot, utilize their talent, and let them go.
Offense, defense once again. Anibogo comes back in for Welsh. Alford at the free throw line.
He and King were high school AAU teammates at one time, right?
Yep.
That's amazing.
And for that team, King was actually a low post guy.
Mm-hmm.
So now you see why he's such a good rebounder.
Yeah, he's got big, strong shoulders. Ball's done a nice job not letting him get a touch over here.
Brown, pump fake, dribbles in, puts up a shot, gets fouled. He'll go to the free throw line.
That's a nice little play. Ball side there, side screen, and then they replay. This is just pretty basketball. Pump, get him up in the air, and then the bang as well. And that's tough to make coming on your shooting side as well.
That foul's against Hamilton, his second. Brown. Makes it a three-point play and a three-point game with 2 minutes to go here in the first half.
Kid's got a confident stroke and a really good defender.
Ball puts it on the floor. Kick out. Hamilton for three.
Now that's a playmaker. Yep. You would have shot the ball, and I would have blamed you. Right at the rim. Roll the dice. Go for the three.
That's what makes him so dangerous, averaging 8 assists a game. Second in the country. Brown hanging with the left. No. And it's out of bounds off of Anibogo. Will stay Colorado ball.
The more you watch UCLA, they're just amazing how they give it up to one another. Great contributions. Doesn't matter who it is. It's all about winning the game. You mentioned six in doubles. But I think they've gotten better at this end, the defensive end. It's just they score so much, they drag people along on occasion. There's that side ball screen.
Shot clock down to 7.
Watch King on the glass now.
Collier slipped, looked like he tripped over the foot of Hamilton. Here comes Holiday.
And a great job checking out by Holiday on King. Nice
the
look.
The no look underneath for Anibogo.
Everybody's a playmaker on this team. Quick timeout, Tad Boyle sees the slippage, the confidence to make play, knowing your teammate's gonna finish the deal.
Largest lead of the game for the Bruins and a timeout called by Tad Boyle, 51-43. Great ball movement, sharing the basketball for UCLA. In a blink of an eye, UCLA has jumped out now to its largest lead of the game. We talk about these guys sharing the basketball. 15 assists on 18 field goals here in the first half.
And again, they just have that feeling with one another, the rapport, both on and off the floor. It's reflected in the way they play. A shuffle cup ball screen and a load up.
Gordon. He got pushed by Anibogo.
He's in your neighborhood, you get pushed. He is a big, strong guy, but I like the call out of the timeout. Challenge him in that low box area, see if they get the big guy going.
It's number 2 against Anibogo, so all big men for UCLA with 2 fouls. Gordon short on the free throw. Anibogo with 2 fouls, Goldman with 2 fouls, Leaf with 2 fouls, Welsh with 2 fouls for UCLA. Something to keep an eye on in that second half as Gordon misses both.
Yeah, he's got to do a job on the up to help them. He's a terrific defender in a way, block shots.
Alford, that's a 2 foot on the line. It's an air ball. Well, the good news for UCLA is that was a two, so it doesn't ruin their three-point percentage because they have been on fire from three-point land.
Steve was telling us, remember, about somebody said, how come you're not a good offensive rebounding team? He said, well, we make a lot of shots. We make a lot of threes.
9 of 15 from three-point land in this first half for the Bruins.
Always fun to hear Steve talk about Bob Knight in reverence, you know, how much he gleaned from that great line. Of course, his dad, too, high school coach.
One of my favorite things here in the stories of their playing days, your playing days, your coaching days.
Yeah, they were comical, I'll tell you that.
Shot clock at 3. White has to put a shot up. He does. And it's out of bounds off of UCLA with 8 seconds. So now Colorado can hold for the final shot. And Tad Boyle says just that. He holds up the index finger. 1-1.
And look at the size of UCLA. They have a tiny team on the floor, which does impact on the glass.
White to Gordon.
Nice hands by Ball.
Gordon puts the shot up, puts it in.
Wow, they need him. Doesn't get a whole lot of points, but if he can ring the bell, put some pressure on the interior D, they might have something come second half.
That may not have been the play that Tad Boyle was trying to run, but it does result in a field goal before the half. Halftime here in Boulder. UCLA leading by 6. The FS1 College Hoops Halftime Report with Mike Hill, Steve Lavin after the break. Back here at the Coors Event Center in Boulder, Colorado. 6-point lead for the Bruins as we get set to start the second half. Justin Kutcher alongside Bill Raftery. And Raf, it's funny, during that first half, we said the pace was favoring Colorado, but 51 points for UCLA, 45 for Colorado. How did it happen?
You got to score. I mean, if you play UCLA, you've got to score. Defensively, I think it's important now, both clubs be a little more solid. The one thing Colorado did, they didn't let them get into that open floor opportunity, and you know, where they can really find people and bury you with those threes. But can Colorado keep it up is the key, I think. You know, you got to stay in touch with this team.
All right, let's take a look at the how this team really kind of came through is look at the first half stats. You mentioned a three-point shooting. It wasn't in transition, but 9 of 15.
It doesn't hurt there, right? Get to the free throw line. Defensively making some stops. And I think Gordon is a guy that's got to give them some productivity. I saw him at the end of the half knock down that shot. But how about the way this club passes the basketball? You just got to get your feet ready. They're willing, able, and unselfish to give it up to one another. The kick, and of course, Holloway is just on fire. This is one of those kids, comes in, does so many things so well, and then Ball, he beats you with a pass, with a drive, with a post up, with a block, and finds people. You see Bryce, it continues. It is contagious, enjoyable to play that way.
A 6-point lead for UCLA to open up this second half. They've won 3 in a row, off their best start since the 07-08 season. Lonzo Ball, right to the hoop for the dunk to start the second half.
And what a read by him. That was an empty side totally, no weak side help. Faulty D.
White guarded by Ball.
And a nice post up for King.
White under the hoop, kick out, Gordon. Shot clock down to 6. Gordon hanging.
Pretty.
Nice move by Wesley Gordon.
Watching him yesterday, this kid can do some damage. So can that kid.
Welsh, spot up jumper, short, and the rebound for Derek White. A big rebound advantage in that first half for Colorado over UCLA.
Good denial in the box area by Welsh. Turn and face and go.
Welsh with 2 fouls. And now we're going to have a 3rd foul called against him.
Boy, playing post defense is really tough. You can use the shiver. And then once the guy makes that move, you've got to release. And the yo-yo game begins, right?
Yep.
They did a pretty good job with their substituting UCLA in that first half.
Welsh goes to the bench. EK Anibogo comes in.
Good
Gordon doesn't want to shoot the three. Stumbles. And now an offensive foul, and this will be called against Wesley Gordon. And that's the first against Gordon.
Is that one or two?
I have it as number one against Gordon. Yep. Are you questioning me?
No, no, I know you're always
right. Are you doubting me?
But I had one down already. He took advantage. Nice little.
Alford off the glass for three.
He was trying to induce a call as well. A little kiss by number 20. Well, you do have to get up on him.
Alford's got.
Ooh, yeah, I thought so. Must be some ice there.
Alford now with 15 points on the night. 56-47 ball. Look at him cradle that ball so nobody could take it away.
A key point right now for Colorado on the precipice. You got to toughen up on this end, and you're right, does a nice job. Again, he reads ahead. No postman, no deterrent, nobody can help out. So clever.
White picked up the foul, his first. Alford, 15, step back, looking for 18, he's got it.
How about that?
And now he's looking at the crowd saying, what? Someone's chirping at him?
Somebody had been chirping with him earlier, though.
Biggest lead of the night for UCLA, now at 12 points.
That door!
Their defense a lot tougher. 2.5 now. Again, they're a nice read. Got the slap. Somebody's got to stay at home, too, to help the guard when there's that empty side. Ball with the giveaway.
First foul against Lonzo Ball. The free throw line goes Derek White. And I thought that was a good take by Derek White right there. He knew he had Ball on him, and Ball was being aggressive. He made sure he put his body into him.
Well, this kid's very clever, very talented. You talking to Ted, he's just hoping he can cultivate, you know, a second guard, a rotation with a third, things of that nature. Up front, I think they're pretty solid. When you think of King making those threes, rebounding. Coach Gordon and Johnson. Johnson's been really quiet of late, hasn't he?
He picked up those fouls against TJ Leaf. Had to go to the bench and hasn't done anything so far in the second half. Baseline jumper for Ani Bogu.
The bench stood up on that one. A bonus.
Remember, he came in for Thomas Welsh. That's the shot that Welsh always makes.
Mm-hmm. Maybe he's taught him, or at least he's learned.
He's been watching.
Nice cut.
King. Good use of the fake. Got a man up in the air, and he'll go to the free throw line.
Ani Bogu, too, with the reach down, I believe.
It is against Ike Ani Bogu, and that's his third. So at the free throw line goes George King.
If there's an area of concern, it's up front, too, with the foul situations for UCLA. Keep going inside if I was Colorado. GG coming in for that reason.
Goleman comes in. Ani Bogu goes to the bench with three, so he's got three. Welsh has got three. Leaf's got two. And Goleman's got two for UCLA. But it's an 11-point lead for the Bruins. Just about 3 minutes into the second half, now a 10-point lead.
Alex Olashinsky is being redshirted too. A kid who had some sort of a foot problem, whether it was a broken foot. Nice use of the bump again to get a look. Goodness.
Alford is on fire here in the second half.
Their horn set, and he is terrific at getting himself prepared to drill it.
He's got all three three-pointers here in the second half. UCLA 5 of 6 from the floor. Alford's got 21 in the game. He's now gone for 20-plus in 5 of the last 7 games for UCLA.
Playing off the ball is his strong suit, no question about it. A little small change on the drive.
And that is at least a good take by Peters, because that's a foul against Alford. That's his second foul. But you bring up a great point. As far as Lonzo Ball is concerned, one thing it's done is it's moved Alford off the ball. Mm-hmm. So now he can come off screens. And he is so dangerous doing that.
He was asked to do so much more last year. I mean, he had to run the show and then be a guy to rent. It was just a very near father-son over there on the sideline. Steve was telling me earlier in the year that, you know, you love your son, no question about it. But the way he dealt with any adversity, never complained last year. You know, people giving him the business, some unfair ridicule on occasion. Look at his little slip to the goal. Gigi.
Yes. Coleman with a dunk.
How about the look, too? The choreographer, Bob Fosse, with the delivery.
Another assist for Ball.
He could have one of those unbelievable assist games some night, don't you think, like at 15, 18?
Absolutely. And that's a two for Xavier Johnson. They need him to get going here in the second half. That's the first field goal in over 3 minutes for Colorado. And an offensive foul against Lonzo Ball on the pass.
Yeah, that's one of the, I'm not so sure on that one, but you see the ability to find people, something he does. Solid performer, he's a little upset on that call, but the blow by, nobody at home. Send it in, finishing himself, and Bryce delivered.
Well, this weekend, the NFC divisional round is only on Fox. First on Saturday, Seattle's Legion of Boom hopes to ground Matt Ryan and the high-powered Falcons. Then Sunday, this is a great one, Aaron Rodgers and the Packers against Dak Prescott and the Cowboys. Coverage begins Saturday, 2:30 Eastern, only on Fox. And speaking of the NFL, here we are in Colorado. Vance Joseph just named the new head coach of the Denver Broncos, a 1995 graduate of the University of Colorado.
Great story today in the local paper about him. Good luck to him and to John Elway and that club. What a weekend with football.
Oh, that game on Sunday, that could be a lot of fun. Well, right now it's a 66-55 lead for number four UCLA, trying to make it four wins in a row, trying to move to 17-1 on the season.
A little box set, a back screen for King, and King gives one.
King hanging, there puts it in.
Nice little call out of the timeout. This is where they got to collectively be a little more alert on the defensive end. Jam when the ball's opposite.
Hamilton. Good defense by King. Better shot by Isaac Hamilton.
Well, you just shake your head if you're the defender. A fadeaway. Knockdown.
I mean, King stayed on his feet. How often do you see a defender do that?
Automatic switch here.
White for three. In and out. That was the rim. We saw that in the first half. Yeah. A bunch of in and outs. Ball quickly
to the
other
way. Pass.
Hamilton for three.
Unbelievable. Bam. You've got plenty of time. You can look at your savings account. Just be ready. Right on the money.
Biggest lead of the night for UCLA. Under 15 to go. King. Short. Johnson the rebound. Trying to save it. He does, but to Hamilton.
Numbers.
Alford. He'll pull up for three. That's his first miss from downtown in this half. There's Leaf. The offensive rebound. No. And they're going to say basket interference against Goleman. And I didn't see that
I didn't either. I didn't either. But how about Leaf running the floor? Involved at one end, sprinting to the other. The unfriendly rims here. And this is because of his effort at the other end. Maybe half, but just got to be a little bit over the rim. Wow. I think you were right. We'll give you a whistle.
Right now, Colorado can use any kind of help possible.
There's that same play UCLA runs in. Screening like a flex cut and then a pop out. And, oh, goodness.
A blocking foul will be called here against Goleman.
And GG's got three also. They're big guys are all saddled. Tried to give ground there. What happens when you got big feet, too?
That's the sixth team foul against UCLA. The first half, it was free throws that kept Colorado in it. That could be the case here in the second half.
And a long way to go.
Johnson for three. And the rebound for Hamilton.
Always put pressure with the push. Get some mismatches on occasion.
Holiday. Ball left open for three. He gets fouled on the three by Dominique Collier. And three free throws coming up here for Lonzo Ball.
Well, that's a killer. It really is. You want to be in a good defensive position. You want to challenge the shot. But it is so tempting. But again, get a foot in the lane. And you just see the sellout totally. You've got to jump stop and put the hand up.
Lonzo Ball knocks down the first free throw. These are his first free throws of the night. Just a 66% free throw shooter. He's 2 of 2 right now, so are you going to play the percentages right now?
I'd say he'll make this one, though.
So you're not going to play the percentages?
Exactly.
Okay.
I would never bet against this kid. He's going to have some storied career because he's the knowledge of the game. You know, the big thing in basketball is guys who can make plays.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you execute, everybody's well prepared for what you're trying to run. Well, then it ends up in players' hands, and who's more capable?
King, shot clock down to 10.
Nice.
As it's blocked by Goleman. Goleman.
Good control, too.
Holiday for three. An air ball. And the rebound comes out to Collier. Up ahead for Wright with the left. Puts it in.
Terrific look. They want a foul at the end of it, but I like that piece of officiating. Terrific outlook. Nice to see the Denisons alert here. They have been subdued.
15-point lead for the Bruins. Samington's three makes it an 18-point lead.
Well, you've got to be alert. Miller definitely was not. That's just a single sprint with a bump on the baseline. You've got to tag the guy and trail him all the way.
The official called the timeout. And with that, we'll take a timeout. 77-59, UCLA an 11-2 run. UCLA leading. They average just under 93 points per game. They shoot it at 42.8% from three. Raph, they're shooting it at 63.6% tonight from downtown.
And it's really, in a sense, a lot of open shots, step-in jumpers. They're running, they're getting their bumps and rubs and positioning themselves in such a way that they get that opportunity. And if Colorado's going to get back in it, they got to pay attention to detail on the offensive end. It's not that they weren't prepared. We watched them go through so many of the options of the offense and of UCLA's offense, that is. But this talent level is pretty deep and rich.
You know, you think about teams as we go on and advance throughout the season, which teams have a legit chance of making that run come tournament time? This UCLA team has a legit chance.
Why is it you always go out on the limb? I mean, you're amazing. The courage to step up and identify one of the premier teams in the country.
Hey, you know,
how
they
many
were,
losses
they,
do they have, by the way?
I believe they have one.
Well, yeah,
but preseason, they were picked third in the conference.
Okay, but that was then. This is now. I do agree with you. I think White had some blood on his. He's coming back already. So took him in the locker room to identify.
Shot clock down to 10. Peters. Gordon. Collier for three. Got it.
He can do that.
Dominique Collier, who missed 9 games this season with a foot injury. Able to connect from three. And Leaf. Good touch with the right hand.
What do you think? I mean, what else can he do? I mean, he's got deep mid, driving, post-up, rebounds with two hands.
Collier again from deep, this time short. Holiday in transition.
Oops.
Gets it back from Ball. Step back for
short.
Three. Contested. It is short, but Leaf gets the offensive rebound. Ball passes up the three, kicks it out. Hamilton, 4-3. He gets the assist, and they get 3 more points.
I mean, it wasn't pretty, but just the way they get that foot in the lane, mainly Ball, Holiday does it as well. And then find people. Tad really upset, but this is just extraordinary offense. Tough. Who do you stop?
A timeout taken here by Colorado. 20-point lead. The stud freshman doing it for himself and getting it done for his teammates as well. A 20-point lead for UCLA in wrap. We went to break talking about Lonzo Ball, the stud freshman. How about TJ Leaf, the other stud freshman for UCLA?
It's really like watching a clinic. He's so fundamentally sound, the technique, the follow-through, the elevation, and how about the blow-by? It doesn't charge. He had two when he made that move. And here running down, finding a teammate. You saw him block a shot. Of course, having a ball, kicking it. And you had an interesting comment during at the end of the season, how many times Ball gets in the lane and finds somebody versus trying to finish for himself.
Yeah. He's just that kind of a player.
Mm-hmm.
And you said he gets great pleasure out of setting up his teammates. Gordon gets fouled by Goleman. I'm trying. I'm watching him. I'm trying to
learn
right now.
That's a cheap shot. That is a cheap shot. I apologize. I just couldn't, you know. You laid it out there.
Get to the foul line. You got 11 minutes to go, so keep attacking if you're Colorado.
Gordon at the line, 3 of 6, now 3 of 7. The foul on Goleman is his fourth. Thomas Welsh comes back in. Goleman goes to the bench. Now Bryce Alford comes in. And Isaac Hamilton goes to the bench.
An 8-man rotation basically every game.
Now with that free throw, Wesley Gordon is now in double figures. And that's four players in double figures for Colorado. Leaf lost it on the way up and a turnover.
What a great look, though. And the time cut was pretty as well. Nice job defensively.
Ball with the steal. Alford gets it back to Ball.
Nice pass.
Alford. And it's Ball flicking it up, and does it count?
No, they wave it. Refs don't understand entertainment. You've got to let that go. Look at this sprint. He is so alert. Gives it, makes himself available. Pretty nice.
Leaf high low with Welsh.
That's not
and
doing
a foul against Wesley Gordon.
He's not doing his homework early there. You've got to be up top, denying the basketball. Tuck in under the rim, you are destined for failure.
Leaf.
Nice entry.
Look at that footwork. Just kept the pivot foot.
Great point. He's so basic. And that's meant as a compliment.
Collier goes baseline. The reverse puts it in.
Tough team to press, too, when you're behind because they all can handle, obviously, finish it fine.
And that's the thing. You've got Ball, who's a great ball handler. Holiday. Alford, who is playing point the last few years. Welsh, the jumper. It's short. Johnson with the rebound.
That's his shot, too. Nice find by Leaf.
Collier fouled on the floor by Ball.
That was a cheapie. That was a nickel.
Not even a nickel dimer.
Yeah, exactly.
Third foul against Lonzo Ball. At the free throw line is Dominique Collier. It's the 8th team foul, so the bonus here for Colorado, 1-1.
Justin, I don't know how you make these movies in front of you without touching them. It's amazing. And the adjustment, I think, nationwide has been terrific by kids. You know, moving, keeping their arms to the side, not reaching in.
All your makes in both. He'll go to the bench. George King comes back in.
Average 92 points, and they're at 84 with 9 and change. UCLA can put the numbers up.
And again, the first half, it wasn't up-tempo. Holiday with a finger roll.
Explosive and tough.
Three, Peters hesitation, looking for Gordon. Gordon gets held. And who's it going to be on?
Wow. Now, this is a young guy who can beat you in so many ways. Breaks down the defense, and George Gervin, alive and well. I don't know.
The foul was called on TJ Leaf, his third. And Gordon at the free throw line for 101. Ninth team foul. Knocks the first one down. Inside. 11 points now for Wesley Gordon, coming off his season high 16 at Arizona. Now 12.
He's got a right foot game. He passes decently.
Ball again, trying to blow by.
Post guys do a nice job being active.
Shot clock at 8, Leaf. Shot clock at 5 for Ball, puts up the 3, no. Leaf trying to keep it alive, out of bounds off of him.
A pretty good defensive set. Not much of an attack mode that trip by UCLA.
That was one of the first times tonight we've seen the shot clock really go down under 10 for UCLA.
And your point, too, not a whole lot of fast breaks for them, yet they're still able to get the numbers.
It's unbelievable.
Efficient on the offensive end. A little high-low, didn't get it to the wing.
Peters, the pull-up jumper, that's for 2, and it's good. 86-71, under 8.5 to go. Does Colorado have a run in them?
It's got to start at this end. He's got that little hook game, too.
Leaf using the body to clear some space, an air ball. White transition through. No, and Welsh with a rebound. Alford was open.
They still do it. Ball,
yep.
He was trying to make a pass. Well, that would have been a big knockdown jumper for Colorado. Give a little bit of a boost. You were right. Thomas Walton had 2 guys down. He had a choice. Alford on the left, Ball on the right.
So can Colorado take advantage? 8:03 to go, down by 15. DeLeon Brown has checked back in, number 5 for the Buffs. White gets bumped by Holiday. Now it's a double bonus. We'll have 2 free throws coming up when we come back. 86-71, UCLA leading Colorado. A 15-point lead for UCLA. 15 assists in the ballgame on 31 field goals. They have 6 players who average double figures. Tonight, they've got 5 players in double figures. Thomas Welsh, the only one who's been off, and he has been off on the floor. Welsh tonight is 2 of 7. He's missed almost every one of those jumpers.
Steve was telling us yesterday, or today, I guess it was, that he always says, what did I do wrong? He's like, say, 6 for 7. What did I do wrong on a shot? You know, you're going to miss one once in a while, but you're right. Tonight, he is just a knockdown shooter from the elbow and that 10, 12, 15 little modest post-up on the baseline.
At the free throw line is Derek White for 2. The front rim's the first. White has 16. That's his first miss at the free throw line tonight. Now 7 of 8 at the line, but we talk about the scores and 86 points for UCLA, and you think it's this up-tempo game. They have 2 fast break points.
But they do push it, get you in a vulnerable position, and then their activity off the ball enables them to score in large numbers, particularly with the threes.
Justin Kutcher alongside Bill Raftery here in Boulder. A good pump fake, 1 dribble, and a miss by Alford.
Now he was wide open, though. He closes out, takes advantage.
White. Good jump stop, couldn't finish. Welsh with a rebound. Here comes Ball, they've got numbers. Alford. And he gets fouled, maybe bailed out at the end as the foul will be called against DeLeon Brown.
You know, as impressed as I was with that drive, did you see the kids run to pick him up? I know teams do it, but they sprint it. And again,
that rapport that these kids have developed for one another, the confidence to give it up, the unselfishness. And Steve saying it's just incredible, a tribute to family and coaching.
Isaac Hamilton is in. Lonzo Ball goes to the bench. Brown goes to the bench for Colorado. Back into the game is Thomas Chiazzilli. 22 points on the night for Bryce Alford. Came in averaging just under 17.
They can all light it up. That's what makes them so difficult.
I mean, you go through a scouting report, and it's who do you try to shut down?
Exactly. Well, let's just say you're a really good perimeter defender. Who do you put him on? I mean, and then the second guy has a very tough athletic body search, and you said that earlier. You know, White really has an understanding how to draw that contact and get a chance for three.
The foul is against Welsh. That's number four against him. And so now going back to the bench is Steve Alford to get Anibogu, who also has four.
Hanging around here. They're right in touch now.
Down by 13 with 7 minutes to go. And again, they're in the double bonus, free throws the rest of the way. They've had the free throw advantage in this game.
They need some D. A little hold. Akazili, you've been waiting for me to say that, I know. And I didn't look, did you notice? I didn't check my cheat sheet.
You can't give out the secrets, Ralph.
I know.
We don't have cheat sheets. What are you talking about?
How do you think I got through school?
I thought it was your basketball prowess. Alford 1-on-1, knocks down the front end.
Gazzilli's got great speed. How about this guy? Four NCAAs, one NIT while he's here, Tad Brawl. They get some players. This could be a tough road trip in the Pac-12. It is already. With Utah and Big Larry, Coach K.
The other Coach K, right?
Yeah, the West Coast of Coach K.
Johnson for three. Again, in and out. That rim is just not kind. 15-point lead for the Bruins. The switch on Alford. Holiday. Alford for three. Got it again.
Catch and shoot. Catch and break it down.
16 points in the second half for Alford. He's got 6 3-pointers on the night. Johnson with the right.
I may have got my goaltender there. Anibogu. This kid hustles and works. Tough.
Chiazzilli saved it, then threw it away. And Tad Boyle's talking with the official Gregory Nixon saying, how is that not goaltending?
I think he may be right.
93-75, UCLA leading.
This is just a buzzsaw, though, offensively, UCLA. I've had them a few times, saw them when they beat Kentucky, at Kentucky.
Holiday draws the foul against Derek White. He'll go to the free throw line for two.
And ball down there to help him up a little bit. You know, Marty Shah-Reyes and I were at a practice at UCLA. Now, he doesn't know much about basketball.
He loves Seton Hall, though.
And he does. I mean, he's got everything blue. And we sat, and I had not seen ball, and all we did was nudge one another on all the drills and a little flair besides, you know, the normal pass he can make, obviously, but always had a little, not showmanship or showing off, but a little pizzazz to his game as well.
Timeout taken here by Steve Alford with his team up by 20 with 5:44 to go. The Bruins have 95 points on the board, still over 5 minutes left. 20-point lead for the Bruins. You were mentioning Lonzo Ball before he went to break, and you talk about all the comparisons, and the one that everyone seems to bring up is Jason Kidd.
Mm-hmm.
And I look at Lonzo Ball right now as a freshman, and I think back to watching Jason Kidd when he was at Cal in the NCAA tournament. Lonzo Ball listed at 6'6". That's taller than Jason Kidd. Kidd was 6'4". But you look at their faces, the haircut, the way they play the game, there really are a lot of similarities, not just in their game, but how they look as well.
It's almost unfair. I mean, that they can be that good. You know, I always say Jason Kidd was with the New Jersey Nets for many years. And if he were playing in the Garden, they would have a statue in front of him at Madison Square. He did things every night that were just beyond description. I mean, just elevated the game and the fun. And that's what this kid does. He's just cerebral, loves the capacities there, but loves the satisfaction of making a play for his teammates.
He's got 8 assists. Colorado has 7 assists as a team on the night.
And this is just a good game for him. Would you agree?
Yeah.
I mean, not super, but a win, and that's what he's all about.
Johnson with a shot clock at 4, knocks down the 3. And now a timeout will be taken by Tad Boyle and Colorado.
They need more of them in a hurry. Xavier able to knock that deep one down.
Both teams with one timeout remaining with 5:15 to go.
Yeah, he was involved in that. I mentioned earlier that little, he was ejected at Arizona State. They had a little, nothing really serious, but I guess they felt there was shoving of some sort. But he is a key to this team in terms of his explosive play.
And Colorado this year, I mean, this is their first home game since December 22nd. Oh. Their first 3 games in conference play on the road. How about this? The first time in 85 years opening conference play with 3 straight road games.
How about that? I mean, that's tough. No question about it.
And then your first home game in conference play. Oh, here's the number 4 team in the country.
Yeah, here we got Babe Ruth and you know, Willie Mays coming in to play against you. 41.
Hamilton, good hedge there by White. Loose ball on the floor. And Anibogo was trying to pick it up and go to the hoop in one motion and didn't get the ball.
He looked like me bending over that ball.
Anibogo goes out, and in is TJ Leaf.
See, when you're muscle-bound, this is what happens.
That's that seeing-eye single.
I can relate. Bodies like that, you just don't have the flexibility of other people.
No yoga for you, huh? Johnson off the glass. No, the follow by Gordon. King goes up for the rebound. He gets fouled. And the foul is against Ball. And that is number 4 against Lonzo Ball.
A little conversation with the officials. You notice that?
I did. Gregory Nixon looked over at him and was like, what'd you say?
Refs aren't real good at having a dialogue with players, and I can't blame them, even for the coach.
George King missed the first free throw. Bryce Peters will come back in, giving Derek White a breather.
Now, putting it together is going to be key for Colorado this season. You mentioned the tough beginning in the conference, but sticking together, competing. And each guy's got to step it up a little bit more. We mentioned early in the game, King making some threes, Fortune, you know, just not being able to get any opportunities to knock him down. The White was tough, I thought. Johnson on occasion, you mentioned the foul problems.
Alford into the corner. Not great spacing right now for UCLA. Alford for 3.
Oh, goodness.
This kid is on fire tonight.
Wow. 27 feet without any problem.
He 7 threes on the night.
He was standing on a buffalo when he made that.
And now a turnover by Colorado. And, you know, we'd be remiss not to say this. Bryce Alford came into the game 9 points shy of tying the great Marcus Johnson for UCLA in career points. Well, he kind of flew past Marcus tonight.
Sure, well, what a great player and guy. You work with him on occasion, right?
I have. Had a full season with him.
Love watching him at UCLA, of course, with the Bucks.
And there is a reason why I said flew past Marcus Johnson, because he used to be able to fly. This is out of bounds off of UCLA. Well, 7 threes for Bryce Alford. UCLA has tied a school record 17 for most 3-point field goals in a road game.
there. I'm Jay. This is Dan. We host Fox Sports Live. We're on tonight after UCLA, Colorado, and the Chargers are on their way to L.A. L.A. kind of feels bad about it, though. And Ice Cube is not the only rapper starting a new basketball league.
That's right. Plus, Steve Lavin joins us in studio to talk Lonzo Ball and more. It's tonight after UCLA, Colorado.
98-79, UCLA is above their season average of 92.8 points per game. A look at the Pac-12 standings. UCLA looking to go to 4-1 with a win here tonight. Utah is at 3-1 because they beat USC tonight.
And Utah will be a formidable opponent, I think.
I agree with you.
Cedric Bearfield, terrific talent. Coming from SMU, and you got David Collette playing the low post, very experienced. If their guards play well, because Kuzma, I think, is a really talented kid. So they got some good inside people. The guards have to step up, make good decisions.
A nice take to the hoop by Xavier Johnson, who's got 18 now on the night. You know, we were talking before about teams, and you said I really went out on a limb by saying that UCLA's got a chance this year.
Now you got another one, right?
Don't sleep on Florida State, and don't sleep on Bryce Alford. Now a new career high, 34 points in this ball game.
So you got to tag his hip and stay with him. I mean, that sounds like not a whole lot, but he's so clever, it's tough to do.
He is 8 of 11 from 3. Johnson off the glass in the paint. That's not an easy shot right there.
But he's got some offense.
Think about this for Alford. He came in to this game. He was 9 for his last 12 from 3. That's 75%. He's 8 for 11 in this one.
Well, playing without the basketball, he is extraordinary. And they give him the ball plenty of time to prepare. He's mixed it up with the dribble, too. He's really out. Look at this. He's having fun. Oh, my God.
37.
He is having a ball. That dance. And look at his steal. They play all the way. Leaf alert.
UCLA has set a new school record with 19 three-point field goals.
They're going to look for him again.
Oh, yeah. Can he get to 40? Holiday finds Alford.
No.
If that went in off the glass, he should go buy a lottery ticket.
He didn't have his balance. He's got to work on his balance.
Johnson, a little scoop shot. Doesn't go, but he'll go to the free throw line.
He's clever, that kid. He's a good player. Do you like this one? This is a little dance. Goodness. And that is one of those, well, coach, help me out. I got to guard this guy. When you give a great shooter all that time and opportunity and confidence, are you going to take him out?
No. As a matter of fact, his dad said to him, I'm giving you one more. I'm giving you one more chance to get to 40. And both the two of them were smiling and laughing about it.
A great relationship.
That's really cool. So we mentioned before, he passed Marcus Johnson, now 15th all-time at UCLA. Up ahead, Hamilton.
Ooh.
Oh,
he was
Lonzo
wide
Ball
open.
Was saying, give it to him, give it to him.
They're going to run the clock down, let him run a baseline now. Here he comes. No.
Back rims it. Peters pulls up for three. That goes. The last UCLA Bruin with 40 points in a game is the guy that Bryce Alford is chasing for career three-pointers at UCLA, Jason Capone.
Jason will run the NBA as well.
He had 44 at Washington State on January 4th of 2003. Leafs three, no good. Johnson the rebound. Just about 45 seconds to go in this one.
104 in a leisurely game.
Interesting.
They average six guys with double figures. They don't get six tonight. They get five, but they also get a career high 37 from Bryce Alford.
Yeah, they got it to him at the right time. A great stroke and the freedom of playing off the basketball has just had him blossom on that end of the floor.
Chiazzilli, they'll put it in with 11.1 to go.
Workmanlike, don't you think?
I tell you what, it didn't seem like they were running up and down, and they put 104 on the board. Impressive by the fourth-ranked team in the country, UCLA, as they defeat Colorado 104-89. A career-high 37 points for Bryce Alford. Couldn't get to 40, but his team gets to 17-1 to start the season, 4-1 in Pac-12 play, as Colorado falls to 10-7, 0-4. For Bill Raftery and our entire crew here in Colorado, I'm Justin Kutcher saying so long. Right now, it's Fox Sports Live with Jay and Dan.